What's going on, everybody? It's Crazy Man here, back bringing you a live... I'm just kidding, this isn't live. bringing you a 2v2 commentary. I forgot the map name already, but it's me and... It's not Candyman this time. It's the Meta88. You may have seen him in my Last Stand videos and stuff. Me and him hopped on for a bunch of games tonight. I think this is like the only one we won, though. But, yeah, this was a really high-action game, actually. I show my mean tactic again. For those of you who know what the mean tactic is... It's against the nid player. And it uses this hero. That's all I'm going to say. Some people are sitting there with a big old smile on their face. I know you are. But, yeah. This is not so much about the gameplay and tactics and stuff as it is... What do I do now? Because me and Mato were talking about it tonight. Retribution is old. It's over a year old. Probably about a year and a half now, as it came out in March last year. I know that's under a year and a half, but whatever. And I think I speak for most of the community when we say we want something different, right? Obviously, this game is good, but it's been the same game for the past 3 years. 4 years, if you actually want to count 2012, 2011, 2010, 2009. Which I have no idea why that works that way, but anyway. Look at this bitch move. I hated that so much. He hated that too. He was pretty angry. But watch this fail stomp. I have to show this. Oh, that was pro. But I want to do something else. Now, I've done this before. And I know a lot of people were like, do what you want to do, man. And then they were like, completely ignore the channel. So I want to do something that you guys will watch, okay? Because it's pointless for me to be like, I want to do something else. And then, like, nobody watches. It's like, well, why even bother then? So I'm going to put a list of games in the description as I'm going to upload this tonight. I'm going to put a list of games in the description. I need to tell myself that twice. Because I know I will forget. I do not edit the descriptions at all. I have nothing to put in them. But look at that. Oh my god. Fucking shit on guy. And I want you to post or rate, whichever way you want to put it, in order from which games you would want to see me play first to last. Because really, this game is old and it's been the same thing and I'm getting a little bored of it. Perfectly natural. That month break I took was awesome, but the past month I've been playing it, and it's just been tiring and not fun. Like, it's been everything you wouldn't want and you wouldn't expect in a video game, so... a couple games that come to mind, Dota 2, I could play some of that. That's, for those of you who don't know, very similar to League of Legends, same gameplay, mechanics, aspect. All that stuff, it's pushy. TDF is back, what the hell? You have weird things. But it's got all sorts of heroes and stuff, and they're constantly updating it. Actually, they just released an update before I patch before I started playing this game. Fear 3, I just picked up. If anybody wants to hop in, we could play some co-op in that. What is this guy doing? I don't even know. He's pulling a crazy. He's just standing by the point. I could play Peumbra Overture. Now, I know a lot of people have seen me play Peumbra Requiem. Or not Requiem. Or no, I have played Overture. Black Plague is the scary one. That is, like, ultra scary. I've played about 5 minutes of it. I mean, I just want to do another game. I know I'm cutting myself off. Battlefield 3, I could do some live comms of. I'm thinking of my list here. You know, just nothing Warhammer related. No offense to Warhammer, but I get bored of the game, right? I'm bored of the game now, and I'm not going to stop playing it, so don't think I won't. Because I'm not going to stop playing this game. I'm going to try and make it a point to hop on once a week and play with a bunch of guys and get you guys some gameplay. It's just I want something that I can consistently go to, have fun, be new. This is why Let's Players are some of the most successful people on YouTube, because they get to play fresh new games, fun new games, and they get to play it all the time. Like, you know, they never get bored of a game because they're always moving on to another game that's something new and different. So that's why they're some of the biggest as well, because the biggest YouTubers as well, because people are like, oh, this is brand new and fresh, and then, you know, there they are. But I feel like this was a really stupid gamble they made right here. Watch this. So he just kind of runs in here and just, oh my god. This Tyranid guy had a rough day, to say the least. The Eldar guy has a pretty rough day at the end too, but look at that Doombolt, just missed. And... oh, they got away. Oh, excuse me, they got away. Very gassy. It's this frickin' water, man. It's tainted. But, yeah, I got a whole bunch of games, and I'm gonna start playing them, and I'm expecting views. Not to say that well, you know what, I'm gonna say it, I am a view whore, but that's just the dumbest statement ever, because, guess what? Why would I put stuff on YouTube if I didn't want it to get viewed? Herp derp. That's right. Suck it. But, I'm also working on becoming part of a, not a clan per se, just a YouTube group. They're called TGN. I'm a branch of that. I'm TGN. I'm working on becoming on TGN strategy. And yeah, it's gonna be cool. I think. Me thinks be cool. But I just wanna know, what do you guys wanna see? No Left 4 Dead either. Funny story about that. I actually want to talk about I know it's super boring to listen to or watch a game that doesn't have actual commentary, that doesn't teach you about the game that I've already taught you about. Look at that. Oh my god. Flamethrowers, yes. And look at this stun. And then he calls down his flame strike. Oh. Sit down. That was actually very synchronized. But His name is Kilplix, or Kilplixism, or whatever you want to call him. Some of you may have heard of him. He was actually a Left 4 Dead player, and he had a group of guys he would hop on Left 4 Dead with, and he would play custom stories, he'd play the main maps, he would do all this stuff, and he would just have a good time. Well, he stopped playing Left 4 Dead, his group, I'll call it, broke up, and all of his fans are like, "Where's the Left 4 Dead, man?" He's like, dude, I'm not playing it. And I kind of feel like I'm in that similar boat, right? Except I will still play my game. He still plays his game, obviously. I don't know much, but he plays a ton of games. He plays Battlefield. Look at that nade. I was so angry that that nade hit like that. It didn't even look like it should have hit, but he plays Battlefield. He's been playing Dead Space. He's played, last couple times, he's played Super Mario. He played some Wii game. It was like Punch Out or Box Out or something like that. It was kind of funny to watch, because his recording software was kind of messed up, so like the announcer dude's voice would turn into like a demon's, and it was pretty cool. And it wasn't intentional either. So yeah, I'm gonna put a link to his website in the description, and he's got a Steam group and stuff, and they always say when he's streaming. He's actually one of my favorite guys now to watch, mainly because, I don't know, he's just funny, I guess, and he doesn't care. Like, it's awesome that he doesn't care. Look at that, fail stun. Oh, I guess that actually worked. Never mind. Look at that awesome stun. That war gear, I tell you, that is just the best war gear ever. I'm gonna call it right now. I mean, my god, the ability to stun infantry in an area, pretty sexy. But now I got the stormtroopers, got them out getting their flames, their flame assault. God damn it, I just thought ice cream and I am so hungry for it now. It's one of those commentaries, it's one of those. But, new warriors are available to join. Yeah, in other news, I was talking about the other games and stuff. The Dungeon Defenders thing is definitely going to have to wait. Look at this Zonthrope. Oh my god. Just get destroyed. I've said that way too many times. That Dungeon Defenders DLC Let's Play thing, that's like on permanent hold right now, because my buddy, who I was going to play it with, got his brother, his younger brother, got like a $100 pair of shoes, and then his younger sister, who is 13 years old, is getting a $500 iPhone. Holy shit. Why would you need a $500 iPhone at age? I'm 17. And I don't even have a phone. What? I don't see the sense in that, but whatever. So, yeah. Doombolts. I think they hit his own guys more than they hit them, but whatever. Whatevs. No, don't kill him! No! Oh, man. But, yeah, I'm jumping all over the place with this commentary, so that's on permanent hold, I guess, until whenever, because he can't get his computer. That sucks. And watch this, I hate the Autarch so much. Thankfully, I managed to dodge most of it right there, and here comes the Nid guy, and I'm just like, alright, come on, watch this. He just kind of backs into the corner, and he just sits there, and, that's GG for him, because he gets jumped. And let's follow the Inquisitor on her journeys through the Tyranids. Oh, she did. It was a nice journey, though. So at this point, I'm going to get to the gameplay now, for those of you who are just dying, getting bored of this commentary. We started to turn around a little bit. I think this is... the turning point is definitely coming up, as you saw the Tyranid guy just killed off my hero. And he's like, nice noob lag! I have no idea why can anyone tell me what he was thinking when he said that? Because I hope he knows that lag does not benefit anyone at all. No one can, like, is like, yes, lag! You know, I have yet to find a person who's like that. Unless they're sarcastic, but I got the Ogryns out. And this is where I start to bring some Tyranids. I have no idea why this guy retreated right there instead of the rest of his units, but he kind of sits there. This Autarch, she just doing work, I guess. I don't know. Here come his Raveners, and there go his Raveners. And, goddamn, that fucking ice cream is taunting me. It's not even in the room. I'm just thinking about it. That's how bad it is. I'm very hungry. But he did get the Mark of Zench. And those missiles just scare them little Tyranids off. Look at all his units. They're, like, technically not there. And, I have no idea why the game is glitched like that, but it is. There we go. They're all back here. And, building a Chimera, because those are awesome, especially for a heavy infantry build like I've got right now. Just right-click on that reinforce thing, and they will just auto-reinforce, and they will go to town. With the Chimera round. His meta is building some bloodletters. It's kind of an interesting battle because, like, it's guardsmen versus Nids, which are two swarmy races, and then it's Eldar versus Chaos, which are two non-swarmy races. They're, like, very important. Their units are tougher and they're very important, whereas these guys are just spammies. But, whatever. I love how bloodletters look. They're so sexy. They do have big swords, though. The swords look taller than they do from this this close-up, but... been wrong before. Look at that. I fucking hate snipers. This is where the turning point... oh, wait. Is it here? I think it's here. I'm not sure, though. Oh, yeah. All of his units are stunned right there. And, no, it's not right there, exactly. I do kill off, like, one more of his squads, I think. Oh, one hit point. Come on, man. Come on, game. And there I shotgun these guys. Everybody, hop into the vehicle and let's get out. And nice charge right there. Did you see that? Knocking all these Banshees down. They don't stand a chance. Here comes his bloodletters and Banshees. You don't stand a chance against Ogryns. And with bloodletters coming in from behind, that's not a good very combo. And these guys... I do believe they kill him. I just kind of chased this guy all the way. I remember this in-game because I played this game just like 10 minutes ago. Actually, this game was played like 2 hours ago, but Watts is just kind of chasing and whoa! Back off there. And here comes this army. That is a really weird animation. You know, I never paid attention to it, but you think they could have the animation of, like, the units crawling out of the hole instead of just spawning? I don't know. Maybe for Dawn of War 3. Which has probably been delayed indefinitely since Company of Heroes 2 is coming out next year. Because we didn't see a trailer at all. And that sucks. That really sucks. But THQ, we all know what they're doing. They're sucking, so they gotta pull out all their big heavy-hitting game franchises, and Company of Heroes was the highest-rated RTS according to PC Gamer, so it's a name people recognize, but just kinda charging in there, and look at the Zonthrop. Sit down, and oh, your Ravenous jumped me, huh? That sucks. Sit down, and the Ogryns. Wait, Warp Spider, sit down. I mean, in case you haven't noticed, this infantry build is really solid. I mean, goddamn. And that was without a guardsman squad, too. That was without the flamers, so he just kinda got owned. And that's the thing, if you can build up a good guardsman ball like I've got right now, oof. They are scary, because they really don't have any area of effect units right now. I mean, this guy should, instead of going tier 3, should be building a Wraith Guard, because Wraith Guard are really good against me, but not so good against Mida and his units. And this guy should be building Suppression. I think he might have had Suppression at one point, but I think I killed it. So really doesn't have a whole lot. He does have Gene Stealers on the way, so that's a good sign, right? Now look at the snipers. Oh, snipers. I was surprised to see snipers, because they are so cool. I love snipers. They're not very strong, but they're cool. Like, they are so squishy. It's awesome. Oh damn, how long is this game gonna last? Only got 3 minutes left, guys. And look at that. That's another glitch that I wish they would fix. He's not there. He's over here. Got a Chaos Dreadnought on the way, which I know what you're thinking. Oh, they have anti-vehicle up. That's a bad idea. Herp derp derp. No, it's not. I'm halfway tempted to just make another Dawn of War 3 wish list, because that brings me to another thing. Why can't this Chimera run them over? Like, why not? As he's calling in, I call him Troll Mines. I don't think he actually calls in Troll Mines. He calls in Rippers. But the Ogryns are the Oreo Ogryns. And look at this. He tries to retreat with his Rippers. Who does that? I only see people, like, throw them away. And, oh, you got your Warp Spider there. Sit down. That's my victory point. And I do believe he gets the Mark of Corn on these guys, or on this guy. Oh, was going Zench there. Now he's going Corn. Milk for the cornflakes. Yeah, that's a corn joke. You can laugh. As he teleports on these guys, and then kind of doesn't work, but you still shoot him a lot. I mean, look at that. That's all while retreating. They were at full health over there, and now they're down. That's a scary ball. It's a very scary ball. Oh, look out. Get out, son. Get on my level. But this guy, this is where the GG move comes up. And it is pretty sad for this guy. Fire Prism on the way for the Eldar Bra. And all pretty high zeal, except for Magicka. He's got a lot of requisition though, and not a lot of power. And I see this guy's flanking around, because the victory points, or this points, give you a sight. Stun all of these guys, drop the call down, GG. I mean, what do you got? All of his small infantry are fried to a crisp. His gene stealers are fried to a crisp. And these guys, you think they're getting away? Yeah, we'll let them get away. No, we won't. Just kidding. So there goes the Tyranid guy's army. And he's like, question mark?
Our kin watch from above.
That's right, just one left. That's what I do. And look at that, look at the destruction. I made it special. This is funny to watch, because you don't get to see this in-game, obviously. So, oh, look at this. Oh, there's anti-tank right in that building over there. Yeah.
A discouraging reversal.
That's game, folks. So pretty much killed. Look at all that Tyranid stuff. That's one thing they did really well with this game. Tyranid junk. But that is game. I thought it was a pretty solid comeback. We were down but not out. And I'm gonna render this video out now. And then I'll probably upload it. As he got champion. I was a little discouraged by that, but hey. As long as we get the W. His resource score like blew mine out of the water. That's where it was. But yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed. Be sure to leave a comment down below on which games you want to see. Peumbra Black Plague is definitely a... maybe a front runner for me. I shouldn't say definitely. Maybe. That and Dota 2 are kind of tied. But it's up to you guys. I mean, I'm up for playing either of those games. And don't just leave the comment... Before I go here. Don't leave the comment of... play Dawn of War 1. Or... goddamn, what was that other comment I was thinking about? You choose, it's up to you. Because I did that before, and they were like, you choose, it's up to you, man. And I was like, cool. So I started doing other stuff, and then it was like, nobody watched. So, stuff you will watch, other than Dawn of War 2. Leave a comment down below. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, be sure to click that like rating, and use that strategy with the Inquisitor and the call down thing. It's awesome. I'll see you guys later. Have a nice day.